Hello, my dear students. Once again, I am here, and this time we are going to start chapter number 8, comparing quantities. In the first exercise of comparing quantities, we will have to study ratio and proportion, percentage. Okay, and these two chapters you have already studied in previous of your classes. So we are not going to discuss any concept. We are simply going to start the exercise. Let us see the first question. In ratio, while you are calculating the ratio, the only thing to be taken care is that the unit of both or whatsoever unit, whatsoever quantity we are there, must be same. Like the first question is, find the speed of a cycle. Find the ratio of the following: the speed of a cycle 15 km per hour to the speed of scooter 30 km per hour. Since the speed of scooter and cycle both are in kilometer per hour, so it is going to remain same. The unit is already same with us. Question number 1, part 1. So what we are going to find, the ratio of speed of cycle to the speed of scooter. The speed of cycle is given as 15. The speed of scooter is given as 30. So 15:30, that is 15/30, on converting it into the lowest form, we got 1/2, that is 1:2. So this was the first question. Similarly, the second part, B part, is saying find the ratio of 5 meter to 10 kilometer. 5 meter to 10 kilometer. Now here what is happening, the units are different. At one place the unit is meter, while on the other one it is kilometer. So we will have to convert both of them in the similar unit. Either we can convert meter into kilometer, or we can convert kilometer into meter. But it is always easier to convert bigger unit into smaller. So we are going to convert kilometer into meter. 1 kilometer contains 1000 meter. That is why it become 5 meter to 10,000 meter. And hence, 5/10,000, 1/2000, 1:2000 will be the answer for this question. And similarly, you will solve the third part of it, in which he is asking you to find the ratio of paisa and rupees. And you can very easily convert rupees into paisa. Okay, now let us see the second part of it. Second question. What question number second is asking from us? Convert the following ratio into percentage. Now ratio is to be converted into percentage. It is also very much same. First part I am doing, second you will solve. It is 3:4. As you know, ratio is nothing but a changed form of fraction only. So 3/4. Now you know very well that how you can convert a fraction into percentage. To convert a fraction into percentage, you will have to simply multiply it by 100. So 4 and 100 will be cancelled, and it will be simply 75%. I'm very sure you can do. And the second part of it is, you can do it, 2:3. So it becomes 2/3 into 100, 200/3, or 66:2/3%. So this way, these are the two parts of question number 2. Now we are having few statement sums. Let us see what the statement sums are saying. 72% of 25 students are good in maths. How many are not good in maths? Okay. So this time he is asking something in statement. Let us discuss that. Question number 3. Total number of students. How many are the total number of students? 25. Percentage of students good in maths. How many of them are good in maths? Don't know. We know the percentage only. 75. So, what about the rest? The rest are not as good as these are. So, percentage of students not good in maths. How we will calculate it? The total percentage is 100. Out of them, 75 are good. So, 25% are not good. 25% are not good. So, now what we will have to calculate? Number of students not good in maths. So, it is 25% of, sorry, a bit of mistake is there. It is not 75, it is 72. So, since it is 72, so this will be 28. So, 28% of 25. Now, 28% means 28 upon 100 into 25. 25 4s are and 4 7s are. So, number of students which are not good in maths in our class is 7 out of 25. So, this was question number 3. Now, question number 4. A football team won 10 matches. Out of the total matches played, if their winning percentage was 40, how many matches did they play in all? Okay, so this time what is given? He is telling us that a football team is there, it has won 10 matches and its winning percentage is 40%. So, how many matches did they play in all? So, this way, what is given? Number of matches won and percentage of matches won. And we will have to calculate the total number of matches played. Okay? So, question number 4. Number of matches won. Kitne? 10. Percentage of matches won is equals to 40%. Let the total number of matches, played is equals to X. Now, total matches are X. Out of this only they have won 40%, na? And that is equals to 10. So, 40% of X is equals to 10. 40% of X is equals to 10. So, what we want to calculate? Number of matches played. Hence, the number of matches played is equals to 40% of X is equals to A. Now 40 upon 100 into X is equals to 10. 0 and 0 is cancelled. So, X is equals to 10 into 10 upon 4. That is 25. Hence, the team played 25 matches in all. Are you getting my point? That team played 25 matches in all. Because number of matches won and percentage of matches won, both are same. So 40% of x is equals to 10. Okay. Next is, once again a statement sum with us. Let us read the next question. This time it is question number 5. Yes. If Chameli had 600 rupees left after spending 75% of her money. Now let's say what is happening. Money is left and percentage is of spending. How much did she have in the beginning? Shuruaat mein kitna? Okay, so once again we will have to subtract it. Money left with her is equals to rupees 600. Ye to money left with her. Okay. Percentage of money spent is equals to 75%. Now, since 75% is spent, how much money is left with her? How much percent money is left with her? That we can calculate by subtracting it from 100. So, percentage of money left is equals to 100 minus 75, that is 25% money is left with her. Now, let the total money be X. If the total money be X, then this is left, this is also left. So 25% of X is equals to 600. 25% of X is equals to 600. That is 25 upon 100 into X is equals to 600. 25 fours are. So X is equals to 600 into 4. That is 2400 rupees. 2400 rupees. So this way we can see that the money left with Chameli is, money Chameli had in the beginning was rupees 2400. What we did, this was the money left, this was the money spent, but this was the percentage. So we calculated the percentage of money left and we have compared these two. That 25% of X is equal to 600. If both the things are same, then we can compare them. Like the matches won was in percentage and the matches won in number were kept equal. Similarly, here money left and percentage of money left have been kept equal. So this was question number 5. Now question number 6. If 60% the people in the city like cricket, 30% like football, and the remaining like other games, then what percent of the people like other games? By simply subtracting it from 100, we will get the answer that this much percent people like other games. If the total number of people are 50 lakh, find the exact number of people who like each type of game. Then we will have to calculate the number of people who like different games. Okay, so first of all, percentage of cricket lovers is equal to 60%. So 60% like love football to play. Percentage of football lovers is 30%. 30% of them like football. So percentage of other games love hundred minus 60 minus 30, that is 10%. 10% of the population like other games. Now, total number of total population of the city. Total population of the city is 50 lakh. We need not to write it in zeros. We will write it 50 lakh only. And then we will calculate the number also in lakhs. Now, people like football. People like cricket. Yeah. Number of people like cricket is equals to 60% of 50 lakh. And I am very sure you can calculate it. This will come around, not exact, 30 lakh. You can calculate it. You will have to calculate. Then number of people like football is equals to 30% of 50 lakh. And I am very sure you can calculate it. So this will be 15 lakh. And then number of people like other games is equals to 10% of 50 lakh, that is 5. So this is all in this exercise. I'm very sure you can do it. Now, tomorrow, in the next video, we will start the second exercise of this. But let me give you an introduction of the second exercise so that you could learn the formula which we have already studied in class 7. So in that, we are going to study many things, some of the application of percentage. Then we are going to study profit and loss. We are also going to study discount. We are going to study tax. Okay. So profit and loss formula I am writing for you. You know very well that when SP is more than CP, it is a condition for profit. And profit is calculated by SP minus CP. And how we can calculate profit percent? Profit percent is calculated by profit upon CP into 100. Similarly, when CP is more than SP, it is a condition for loss. So loss is calculated by CP minus SP, and loss percent is equals to loss upon CP into 100. Got my point? Similarly, one more formula is there, that if profit percent is given, then 100 plus profit percent upon 100 into CP. This is the formula for calculating SP and CP in case of profit. Because with the same formula, we can calculate the CP. If we want to calculate CP, so 100 will go up, 100 plus profit will come down. So 100 upon 100 plus profit percent into SP. Similarly, if there is a loss, the only change is 100 minus loss. So 100 minus loss percent upon 100 into CP, and same way we can calculate it here also, 100 upon 100 minus loss percent into SP. So these will be the formula, these are some of the formula going to be utilized in profit and loss. I'm very sure you will learn them, and then tomorrow we will try to solve some of the questions based over these formula and of exercise 8.2. Till then, complete your work. Take care.